This is a video of submucous fibroid. It was a big size submucous fibroid. Now what we have started doing is systematic mapping in the uterine cavity with a diagnostic hysteroscopy using 2.9 hysteroscope. Now you can see left tubal ostium, right tubal ostium, and the fibroid is on the posterior side. Now once this has been, basically here we are using normal saline as a distension medium and hysteroscopic morcellator. Now the advantage of morcellator here is it mechanically cuts the submucous fibroid. Energy source is not used, and so you can use normal saline as a distension medium. Now it cuts the tissue, it morcellates the tissue and sucks out inside the bag. So the greatest advantage of hysteroscopic morcellation is you can remain within the capsule. You can gradually go on doing, you can see that the terminal blade is vibrating, is going out and in, out and in, and it is cutting the tissue and immediately sucking out the small beds of a fibroid inside the, this is the capsule. Can you see this? This is how, if you keep the capsule intact, then possibility of the myometrium going inside this will be less. So this is the clear-cut advantage over resectoscopy. See, this is the blood. Whatever a method you do with resectoscope, some part of endometrial tissue or myometrium will come. But with this resectoscope, you can see the blood. It is only cutting the fibroid, not anything else. And it helps us to remain within the capsule. See this blood? Can you see this blade? I am moving. So you have to see that the cutting part remains towards the fibroid and it cuts the tissue. See, this is the blade. Okay. Can you see this? I am rotating. Yes. Now, once this is the capsule and this is the fibroid on another side. So this is how the blunt part is remained towards capsule and the part which is cutting is towards fibroid. It's gradually small pieces, chips of the fibroid is being cut and is sucked out. So this is the beautiful way, is the new generation hysteroscopic morcellators are going to come in a big way. The only disadvantage with this particular hysteroscopic morcellator is very expensive, but I think with cost reduced in future is going to be accepted by all. The greatest advantage of this is you can do a bigger size fibroid resection, you can do multiple fibroid resection, you can even do a resection of which is only partly endometrial but majority of the part is in the myometrium, intramural part, then also you can do it. Because if the capsule remains intact, it is the terminal part of this morcellator which oscillates, vibrates and cuts. Can you see the capsule and fibroid clearly? It hardly affects any endometrium. So this is the beauty of this particular instrument. So you have to be a little gentle, and when normal saline is used as a distension medium, you don't need to worry because if the blood vessels are not opened, so the absorption of fluid is again likely to be very less. So unless myometrium, endometrium or blood vessel is cut, the picture, the field remains clear and it will not distract your operative field. It only just cuts the fibroid. So this was about 4 to 5 centimeter fibroid, and now what I'm cutting is the intramural part of fibroid. So when you want to cut intramural part of the fibroid without cutting endometrium and myometrium, which is extremely difficult with resectoscopy, and you can see that what you have to do is you have to get the correct angle. This is the capsule, this is the fibroid. So the cutting morcellator is gradually cutting the fibroid chips, parts, and doing a suction and bring it out immediately. So you don't need to remove it with the home forceps. That is another advantage of the hysteroscopic morcellator. So gradually, you have to focus that the blade, cutting blade of the morcellator is remaining towards the part that you want to remove, I mean the fibroid, cervicus, fibroid part. And this is the capsule and this is the fibroid. Can you appreciate this? How beautiful it is cutting. This is the only part left now. So gradually, we're taking care that it doesn't go beyond the capsule. You have to cut only the fibroid part. Very promising technique and likely to be very popular as the cost is reduced in future. You can see that how beautiful it is gradually morcellating and sucking out from its target place. Can you see the capsule now only left? The whole fibroid is being out, and this is the capsule which is left at the end of morcellator. Can you appreciate everything, every bit has been removed and only the part of the capsule is left behind. See this, completely removed, and even endometrium and myometrium intact surrounding this fibroid. That's the beauty and advantage of this particular instrument. This is from the Smith-Nephew company, and this is a very wonderful instrument. This is the end result, you can see. Do your mapping and you see that there's nothing left behind. And fibroid from the posterior wall is removed completely. Okay. So the reconfirmation that there is no other fibroid anywhere left, and the fertility enhancing surgery we are completing, and these are the bits. Can you appreciate this, which has been sucked?